Is Propecia a lifetime drug for hair loss? I'm 19, suffering from male pattern baldness. I want to know that if I start using Propecia and Rogaine, will I have to continue using these drugs for my whole life?
Thank you for your question. You're 19 years old, and you're asking if you start Propecia or Finasteride, as well as Minoxidil or Rogaine, will you need to continue these drugs to maintain your hair for the rest of your life? Well, I can give you some guidance based on your question and how we counsel our patients in our practice. Just a little bit of background. I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic and reconstructive surgeon. I've been performing hair loss treatment, including hair transplant, as well as medical and non-surgical treatments. And I've been in practice for over 20 years. In fact, I'm the founder of TrichoStem Hair Regeneration Centers. And this treatment we developed in our practice over several years, we have now been able to deliver to patients outside of our offices using a method combining platelet-rich plasma and acellular matrix, amongst other things. And so we can certainly, we spend every day of our practice counseling patients on medical, surgical, and non-surgical options for hair loss. So as far as your question is concerned, you have the benefit of a long history of experience since minoxidil was first used by prescription only in 1988, and finasteride or Propecia has been around since 1997. Now, that being said, I can tell you that in my practice, when we meet patients who have been on these drugs for this length of period of time, majority of them, if not all of them, it's probably a skewed view because these are people who are still losing hair. They still lose hair. The benefits of the drugs still have a certain limitation. Finasteride, if you've done your research, you've learned, is a drug that's a pill that you have to take daily to inhibit an enzyme called 5-alpha reductase. This is the enzyme responsible for the conversion of testosterone to dihydrotestosterone, or DHT. It is generally quoted that 60% of men will respond to finasteride. What this means is that only 60% of men may have DHT-sensitive hair loss. So the idea is you reduce the DHT, you allow continuous hair growth. As far as minoxidil is concerned, this is a topical preparation that's still the true mechanism remains not well defined. However, clinically, we've all observed that it appears to prolong the growth cycles of thinning hair, as well as stimulate short-term hair growth. In a pharmacologic model, if you are responsive to these drugs, then you need to take these drugs as recommended. So for finasteride, you have to take a pill every day. For minoxidil, you have to apply it topically, and that it can be customized to a degree. In our practice, we have learned a long time ago that it is challenging for people to continuously take a drug. Currently, there's a lot of concerns about the long-term sexual side effects of finasteride, and people are very often questioning whether or not there is a true value to the continuous application of minoxidil. We know that the drug does have value from a scientific perspective, but it may not have the consistency that people want in order to see the benefit. That being said, we have had the opportunity in developing a procedure called hair regeneration. And I was alluding to this when I talked about TrichoStem hair regeneration. Basically, a lot of people are coming to us from around the world for a non-surgical treatment that is very different from the pharmacologic approach to hair loss. What we've been able to establish that 99% of men and women with pattern genetic hair loss who come to us with essentially a single treatment are able to maintain and not only stop the progression of hair loss, but have regrowth of hairs that are not actively growing, as well as a reversal of the thinning process, so thinning hair becomes thicker. And at this time, we see with more than 5 years of data that the hairs do continue to grow. We do customize, and there are some people who will do a second injection somewhere around 15 to 18 months, and we're always continuously evolving the procedure. But the advantage, the significant advantage, is that our rate of response for male pattern hair loss exceeds the response of finasteride and doesn't even compare to minoxidil. Majority of our patients, once they have we have done this treatment, we have them, we don't ask them to be on either drug. If they choose to be on those drugs, they can be, but essentially they don't need to take those drugs. We find that majority of people who come to us, particularly for male pattern hair loss, do not want to take finasteride at all, or have taken it and had issues with side effects. So in reality, we can only encourage them to use any other medical treatment, but we've been able to establish success with hair regeneration as a standalone treatment. So that being said, this is a distinction, and it's intended to help you differentiate a surgical, non-surgical, and medical and pharmaceutical. In the pharmaceutical model, you take a drug, you get the effect. If you don't take the drug, you don't get the effect. So the question of using it for the rest of your life, the answer is, if you are a responder, then most likely yes. Compliance has always been a challenge for hair loss medications, whether it's oral or topical. So this has also led to a lot of consistent interest in our treatment. We treat patients from all over the world. And as an alternative to the surgical hair restoration, which has benefit and value, but our goal is to catch people early enough so that we can strengthen their hair, give them the coverage that they're looking for, and avoid surgery as long and as much as possible. So to answer your question, if you're a responder, you will need to take it as long as you can, barring side effects. Otherwise, you may want to consider also learning about treatments like hair regeneration. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck, and thank you for your question.